little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wondering love. All morning stars together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his heaven. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in.
Hello, and a very warm welcome to worship from Wooler URC. It's great to have you with us today, wherever you're joining us from. And you're joining us on the third Sunday of Advent. And you can see that, like a lot of people, we've felt the need to put our Christmas decorations up a little bit earlier than usual this year. It's not altogether surprising. For obvious reasons, it's been a very difficult year for so many people. It's been a year that has been full of disappointment for a lot of folk. And we could all think about things that we've missed out on. Parties that haven't happened, holidays and travel arrangements that have to be put off until another time, gatherings that just couldn't take place, meeting up with family and friends that just we've not been able to do at the moment. We've all had disappointments. I'm going to be chatting with Fliss later on in our service. Fliss has had to face up to a particular disappointment in her life earlier this year, and she's going to tell us a little bit about that. And then later, Rachel is going to delve into the Psalms for us and uncover a message of hope that we all need to hear very badly. I'm reminded of the words from the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah was an Old Testament prophet, and in his book, as he spoke about the truth of God, he wrote this. He said, "I will bless you with a future filled with hope, a future of success and not of suffering." We hope and pray that in our service today, you'll all hear a message of hope and encouragement from God. And as we get nearer to Christmas and we prepare to celebrate the coming, the birth of Jesus, we remember anew that Jesus is indeed the gift of all hope, the gift of love from God, come down to be with us, Emmanuel, to love us and to save us. And so with that in our hearts, we worship together today.
We are waiting for the light to grow, waiting for God to restore and renew us. Three candles burn, signs of hope when the days seem dark. God of restoration, Come to us in our disappointments. Walk alongside us in our sadness. Share with us in our joys. May your hope live within us, burning as a light in our lives.
Fliss, hi there.
Hello.
Thanks ever so much for joining us. Fliss, in our services at the moment, as you know, we're looking at finding hope in tough times. And we've been thinking about all sorts of different experiences. But you had a particularly tough time this year. Today we're thinking about disappointment. And you had a number of disappointments, I think. Maybe you could tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, so, well, it's been a funny sort of year. So Carl and I were due to get married this year. We've been engaged about 3 years now, and I think we've been saving up for the wedding for about 2 years or so. And yeah, it's funny, all my friends got married in 2019, and we sort of, you know, we went to everybody's wedding, and we sort of said, oh, it'll be our year next, you know, we're so looking forward to it. And then sort of January, February, it came along, and we sort of noticed the virus arriving. We thought, oh, it'll be fine by August, it'll be fine. And then obviously went into lockdown, and we thought, oh, it'll be fine. And then as the year progressed, we realized that the wedding wasn't going to look like we had envisaged it was going to look like. So we had lots and lots of meetings at Slaley Hall, who were brilliant and so patient with us. And we got our heads around to the fact that we would have a wedding with 30 people, and we'd made all the arrangements and adjustments, and we'd phoned everyone and told them. And then about a week before the wedding, Boris Johnson decided to pause weddings for 2 weeks. And yeah, the disappointment we felt was just, it was really hard, because we adjusted to what we were going to do. We decided and we made all those decisions, and then at the last minute weren't able to have it. So we were very disappointed. So it's been a funny sort of year. So we've had to postpone the wedding a year.
Yes. And that happened more than once, I think, didn't you? Because you had plans.
Well, we do, because Slaley Hall kept changing their minds and said, no, you can't have it. Oh, yes, you might be able to have it. No, you can't have it. And then we'd sort of, because we had sort of family sort of concerned about reducing the numbers as well, so we weren't sure what to do. And then we decided we definitely did want to do it. And then we'd made that decision. And then obviously it was taken out of our hands at the last
time.
And then we thought about postponing it. Yeah, we thought about postponing it till October, and then obviously we're very glad now that we didn't make that decision, because obviously things are just the same. And we're hoping, again, this is hope, that by August next year we'll be able to have the wedding that we would like.
Okay, well, really good. So let's hope so for next year. But yeah. How does that make you feel with all these changes and disappointments going through, and you know, you're somebody who's studying for ministry, you're a person of enormous faith. Where was your faith in all of these ups and downs?
Well, my faith never really wavered. I mean, I'm always one that believes that God knows what he's doing, and God is in charge, and God is looking after us. And we, Carl and I, are both on the same page in this, and that we feel that really, we've been very lucky throughout this whole process, that we know and we're aware of people that are going through much worse times than we are. You know, Carl has kept working throughout this pandemic. Mm-hmm. I have just been at college. You know, we haven't lost our jobs. We haven't been furloughed. We haven't had any family or friends, thank goodness, who's been poorly with the virus. And so we both kind of reflected, Carl and I, that even though we've been disappointed, we've been very lucky. We're very grateful for being sort of as lucky as we are. And I think God has looked after us in this whole thing. And to be honest, I think as well, I've come around to it now, that I think that when we have the wedding next year, it's going to be even more wonderful, I think, because, you know, it's going to be a proper celebration. People are going to want to have something to celebrate. People are going to be so excited to be together, to be able to hug and see each other. You know, I've not seen my friends for the entire year. You know, I've not seen some of my family members the entire year. So I think by the time we actually get to the wedding next year, it's going to be fantastic. I mean, this is me hoping that everything's going to be normal by August, with the vaccine hopefully coming. I don't know whether I'll be able to. We don't know what August is going to look like, but I'm very hopeful and I have faith that it's going to be better than the situation we're in now, I think.
Yeah. So if you had to sum up your hope in this situation, just in a few words, how would you do that?
I hope that one of the things I'm hoping for at the moment is that so much hope is in this vaccine at the moment. And I'm watching sort of the news, and I'm hoping that people who are administering the vaccine and people who are looking forward to it and people who are waiting for it are not disappointed too much. You know, I think so much is being pinned on this vaccine that I just hope that if it manages to be okay and we don't, you know, it doesn't go wrong. I just hope that I can get married next year. I mean, Carl and I both agreed in the end that it doesn't really matter how many people are there as long as we can get married. And I think that's what was disappointing, is that we couldn't even get married at all. So I hope that I can get married and, you know, look forward to my career and sort of just being happy, I guess. Yeah, that's what I'm hoping for.
That sounds good. We share your hope. That the wedding comes off and the queuing comes off you
yes,
and Carl,
thank you ever so much.
A day to remember and a real celebration. I'm Absolutely. Sure you will. Thank you for sharing your hopes and your faith with us. That's really good and we really appreciate it.
Thank you very much and God bless.
And you. Bye.
Bye.
Good morning. Today's reading is Psalm 139, verses 1 to 12. You have searched me, Lord, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all my ways. Before a word is on my tongue, you, Lord, know it completely. You hem me in behind and before, and you lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me and the light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. Have a happy Christmas, everybody.
So we come today to reflect together on the theme of disappointment and what that means in terms of the Advent theme of hope. We come to listen to Scripture and hear what God is saying to us. I think it's fair to say that possibly the whole world is united in thinking that 2020 has been a year of disappointment. So many plans have been made that have had to change. So many plans that have had to be cancelled or rearranged, or as Fliss and Carl found, rearranged only to be cancelled again. So many things haven't happened as we expected. Important stages of life, leaving school, starting school, even going to school. There have been disappointments along the way. Not being able to go to church, not being able to socialise in the way we would like to. Lots of disappointments that we have all experienced. And yet, as well as being a year of disappointment, 2020 has also been a year of loss for so many people. People who've faced bereavement, people who face the loss of livelihood, the loss of income, people around the world who have been plunged even deeper into poverty, people still living with conflict that has fallen off the headlines because COVID bags them all. And as we reflect on 2020 being a year of loss, the temptation is to minimise our disappointments, to say, well, you know, it could be a lot worse and people are far, far worse off than I am. But disappointment matters as well. And you don't have to be a psychologist to know that bottling up feelings around disappointment, especially negative ones, is not healthy for our body or our mind, or especially for our soul. Even when we feel there is no one we can really offload to about the disappointments we face, how they really make us feel deep down inside, God is always present God is always there to listen and to understand. Psalm 139 is a great psalm to remind us of that. It's one of my go-to passages in the Bible. And sometimes I'll take a week or so to read a verse or two each day and just hold them within me to be reminded. To be reminded that God has searched us and known us. God knows when we sit down and when we rise up. God discerns our thoughts from far away. Even before a word is on our tongue, God knows it completely. Our God does not have a hierarchy of love, far less a hierarchy of needs. Whatever our needs are, they are important to God. God's love encompasses the whole globe and every living being within it. And yet our particular needs are special to God. We can share our disappointment with God. In this season of Advent, our Advent hope is centred on the coming of Jesus, and one of the names given to him at his birth was Emmanuel, God with us. God with us. The God who has searched us and known us is with us. And Jesus, in his earthly ministry, in his every word and action, revealed the love of God. Revealed the love of God to real people with real disappointments. In Psalm 139, we're told that God hems us in and lays his hand upon us. So many times, Jesus, God with us, laid his hand gently on those with need, those living with disappointment. And through his life and death and resurrection, opened the door wider than ever before for us each to walk through and to know God's transforming love for ourselves. And therein lies our Advent hope, that not only will God listen to our disappointments, not only does God understand them and understand us, God's transforming love revealed in Christ will help us walk through our disappointments to move to a new place, not the same place as if the disappointment hadn't happened, but a renewed place. God's timescale is eternal, and as we're human, frustratingly, that means that God does not work to our timescale. We cannot say that by this time next week or this time next month, we will have worked through our disappointments. But the hope is there, the sure and certain hope of God with us in Jesus, walking with us, helping us through our disappointments, not minimizing them, not discarding them, but putting them in God's perspective of fullness of life. The psalmist also says about God that the knowledge of God is too wonderful for human minds to understand, so high that we cannot attain to it. And yet, in the coming of Jesus, that tiny, vulnerable baby born into a world of turmoil, in Jesus, we find that knowledge revealed to us. God is with us, our sure and certain Advent hope. Amen.
Prayers for others are based on Psalm 13. The psalmist cries out to God in great disappointment, but also trusts God as the source of all hope. Our prayers will be interwoven with the verses of the psalm. Let us pray. How long, Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? We pray for those who feel forgotten and unseen, that they may know they are remembered and seen by you, God. Help us to partner with you to remember the forgotten. Search our hearts to reveal those we hide our faces from, the outcast, the stranger, and the homeless. Let us turn our hearts and faces towards these people and see them as your beloved children. How long must I wrestle with my thoughts and day after day have sorrow in my heart? How long will my enemy triumph over me? We pray for those we know who struggle with mental illnesses, anxiety, and depression. We pray that there will be resources released to help, enough staff employed, and finances given towards mental health services nationally. Help us to be a friend and a listening ear to those who suffer. Fill us with compassion and wisdom. We pray for those who wrestle with sorrow, that they may know your victory over those dark thoughts which currently seem to triumph. Look on me and answer, Lord my God. Give light to my eyes, or I will sleep in death, and my enemy will say, I have overcome him, and my foes will rejoice when I fall. We pray for ourselves and for all those who need your restoration and grace. Help us not to judge or exclude, but instead to lift people up in prayer and embrace them with the grace we all know in Christ. Thank you, loving Father God, for hearing our prayer. And like the psalmist, we proclaim, but I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing the Lord's praise, for he has been good to me. We gather all our prayers together into the prayer that Jesus taught us to say. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah.
we all need to find afresh the hope that comes from God. All of our journeys and all of our circumstances are different, but as a church, we aim to welcome everybody. So just a reminder that if you need somebody to listen to you or to pray for you, then do feel free to call us, email us, or contact us via the website. The details are on the screen, but do get in touch. Now, there's just time today to tell you about our arrangements for Christmas, because of course the restrictions are continuing, so we're not able to gather for worship in the same way that we've done in previous years. So things are going to look a little bit different this year, but let me tell you about the services that we have going on for Christmas week. So firstly, on the 23rd of December, we'll be putting online a service of carols and readings. We can't sing together in church at the moment, so we've got a beautiful carol service that you can enjoy at home and join in with and sing out your favourite carols to your heart's content. So you can watch that whenever you like over the Christmas period, but that goes live on our website and on YouTube on the 23rd of December. And then on Christmas Eve, we've two services so that we don't have too many people in the church building at one time. First of all, at 11 o'clock in the morning, there's a short service of readings and prayers in the church building. And that's going to be a nice, peaceful, quiet time so that you can gather and focus on the true meaning of Christmas. So that's 11 o'clock on Christmas Eve. And then later on the same day, at 6 o'clock in the evening on Christmas Eve, there's going to be a carol service to listen to and readings, and Bill is going to be bringing us a message of hope. So that one is at 6 o'clock on Christmas Eve evening. And then on Christmas Day itself, there's no service in the church building, but there's a short family service online so that we can all celebrate Christmas together. So you can look for that on our website and on YouTube on Christmas Day morning. And then on the Sunday after Christmas, the 27th of December, there isn't a service either in the church building or online. We've given the team a well-earned break so that they can have a rest with family as well. So next week we have our service online as usual, the last Sunday before Christmas, and we look forward to seeing you again then. But a prayer for us all as we finish. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So we look forward to seeing you again next time, but until then, keep safe, keep hopeful, keep celebrating the coming of the Son of God. See you next time. God bless.
Hear the angels sing, there's hope for everyone. To announce our King, there's hope for everyone. What good news they bring, there's hope for everyone. Angels sing, there's hope for everyone. They came from afar, there's hope for everyone. Wise men saw the star, there's hope for everyone. Shepherds heard the choir, there's hope for everyone. From afar, there's hope for everyone. We are waiting on the promise for the one who lights the darkness, bending low to be among us. Bring your glory in the highest, Jesus, come. let us adore. There's hope for everyone on the manger floor. There's hope for everyone. What are you waiting for? There's hope for everyone. Come adore. There's hope for everyone. We are waiting on the promise. Thank you.